Welcome to the Web Development Complete Roadmap. This is a step-by-step guide designed to help you learn web development effectively using the TLLC method: tools, languages, libraries and APIs, and core concepts. I'm Srinath Warrior, AI Engineering Manager from Bangalore. Let's get started. Every successful web development journey begins with mastering the right tools. Here are the essentials. A code editor. Start with a lightweight and versatile editor like Visual Studio Code. It is beginner friendly, has extensive plugins, and it also works great for advanced users. Version control. Try to learn the basics of Git for tracking changes in your projects and managing code between your team members. While Git is a software that you use, the tool would be either GitHub or GitLab. Browser dev tools. For web development, familiarize yourself with Chrome DevTools or what we commonly call as Inspect Element. This helps you understand the basics of client-server architecture. Learning these tools early will save you hours of frustration and make your development process much more smoother. But remember that this is just the first level in TLLC. Don't waste too much time in deciding which tool to pick. There's always going to be a shiny new tool out there, and in the long run, it doesn't really matter. Moving to the second level of TLLC, languages. Languages form the foundation of web development. Now, when we say web development, it is not just UI development. Because if you want to build real-world websites or web apps, you can't just make a static UI page. You need a backend that the UI calls and fetches data from. So let's look at what languages you need, both for front-end and back-end development. Let's start with front-end languages to build your website or web app. HTML lets you create the structure of web pages. Think of it as a skeleton of your website. Once you understand the basics of HTML, you won't really care too much about them on a daily basis. CSS is used to style your web pages. That includes the font, the size of texts and images, the color, and all the visual elements on your screen. Make sure to really understand the techniques like flexbox and grid for responsive layouts. Now, HTML and CSS are basically just tags that you add for your structure and look of your website. But JavaScript is the programming language for web development. With JavaScript, you can add logical functionality to your website. It lets you write code for button clicks, animations, accessing your server database, and many more things. Now let's move to the backend stack. While there are multiple languages like Java, Ruby, PHP for backend development, your simplest way to get started is with JavaScript again. And in this case, easy doesn't necessarily mean bad. Because with knowing JavaScript, you can do practically everything on the backend, and it also helps for your UI development. Once you're comfortable with JavaScript, you can also move on to TypeScript, which is more like an advanced version of JavaScript. JavaScript is not a typed language like Java, but TypeScript is a typed version of JavaScript. So a lot of runtime errors can be handled much better with TypeScript. The other language for backend dev is SQL. SQL is primarily database querying. So this becomes helpful when you have a database table and you want to fetch data out of it for JavaScript to read. Now let's move on to level 3 in TLLC, which is libraries and APIs. Now when you see a website like Facebook.com by Meta or YouTube.com by Google, you might think that all the code written to build such a website is built by that one company. But this is not true at all. In reality, applications are more like a multi-floor building where the company writes only some of the floors, and many of the floors are built by different other companies, some freely available and some paid. These freely available projects are what we call open source projects. And a typical web application would contain hundreds of such libraries and projects. So you can use something called Node Package Manager or NPM to easily manage all these libraries and use them in your code. NPM gives you easy access to more than a million libraries. And these libraries help you build faster and more efficiently. So now that you have an idea on how coding projects look, let's start understanding some libraries. For front-end libraries, learn React.js or its more advanced version Next.js for building interactive user interfaces. Next.js is highly in demand and very beginner friendly. There's an excellent introduction tutorial to Next.js by Vercel, the company that created Next.js, which can actually help you really get started. You can also use Vercel's V0 to build a UI with AI. But as always, I would recommend you to understand what's happening under the hood instead of blindly using the AI tool. For backend frameworks, if you are using Next.js on the UI, you'll automatically be using Node.js to build your server-side backend logic. Both Next.js and Node.js mainly require JavaScript knowledge. Of course, there are millions of NPM libraries for you to use, like Express.js, which is a minimal framework for building APIs and handling server requests. APIs. Just like you can add libraries created by others to your project, you can also call APIs by other companies. But in the case of APIs, you are not copying their code to your project. The API is hosted on that other company's server, and you are just fetching the data into your app. Learn how to consume RESTful APIs to fetch or send data. So, for example, if you want to show a Google Map location on your website, you can call the Google Maps API and it'll send you a location image via API and you can show that on your UI. Databases. Now, to save data in database tables, you can start with MySQL, Postgres, or MongoDB to understand how data is stored and retrieved. You can also start with a tool like Supabase to store data and easily integrate with Next.js. It's impossible to list all the libraries here, but as you get started, you'll slowly gain knowledge on all of them with time. And finally, the most important level in TLLC is the core conceptual knowledge. This knowledge will set you apart from the majority people who simply copy-paste code. The important question to ask at this level is why? Why do these tools, languages, libraries, or concepts exist? Let's look at some of these concepts. Responsive design. Build layouts that adapt to different screen sizes using concepts like media queries. Authentication and security. Learn about user authentication and authorization using JSON Web Tokens or JWT and securing your application with HTTPS and basic encryption techniques. Version control practices. Understand branching strategies, pull requests, and how to collaborate with your colleagues on Git. Performance optimization. Learn techniques to reduce load times, optimize assets, and improve your performance metrics like rendering time. DevOps. Understand what happens after you push your code to GitHub. How does that code actually convert to a full-fledged application with UI and backend and all the libraries working together synchronously? The best way to learn is by building. So here are some project ideas for each stage of your journey. For a beginner level, build your own resume website using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. It can be a simple static website, so you don't need a database or even any complex animations on the UI. For an intermediate level, enhance the same resume website but add a blog to it. You can use Next.js on Vercel and an API like Google Maps API. You can host the website on Vercel for free. For an advanced level, build a full-stack hospital booking management site with Next.js and MongoDB and a payment gateway integration like cash-free payments. Many beginners get distracted by level 1 to 3, shiny unnecessary tools and libraries, because there's always a shiny new tool which feels easier to use. But level 4 of understanding concepts is what actually helps you build great products, get a job, and grow in your career. So avoid learning too many frameworks all at once. Stick with one front-end and one back-end framework initially. In the beginning, don't spend too much time on building everything yourself, like complex animations or niche features. As you go further, you'll realize that there are sufficient libraries to help you build these things. Focus instead on mastering the basics. Web development continues to be a top field in 2025. These are some average salary ranges as per Glassdoor. Front-end developers have an average salary of 6 to 12 lakhs per annum in India. Back-end developers have an average of 8 to 15 LPA. Full-stack developers have around 10 to 20 lakhs or more with experience. But honestly, these are only average values. Well-funded startups and top MNCs can pay you much more, but you'll have to ensure that your level 4 concepts are very strong. So that's your roadmap. Follow the step-by-step process, stay consistent, and keep building projects. Web development is a journey, and with the TLLC method, you'll have a clear and structured path. Don't forget to subscribe to learn and earn more with AI and tech. Thank you for watching.